those handheld radios.
They did choke. I'm going to show you a couple of highlights from college basketball.
Sarah was also nurturing a new career at a local TV station.
Yeah, Iditarod, of course, is the biggie, but it's not the only mushing going on.
She started out as a sports anchor and KTUU weekend news, and one of the viewers called in and said something to the effect that, well, you've taken out the old guy and replaced him with a bimbo, which she found highly amusing.
At the same time, the relationship with Todd was taking off. One fall day in 1988, Heather planned to meet Sarah and Todd at the state fair, but the two never showed up. Instead, they headed to the courthouse and learned they needed two witnesses to be married.
They walked across the street to the Pioneer home, the old folks' home, asked in the lobby if somebody would like to be their witness, and a couple volunteers, one had to wheel the other one out and push the other one out in the wheelchair across the street to the courthouse. I don't think they had rings. I'm not even sure.
Sarah's father, Chuck, took the news well.
They eloped. Were you mad?
No, I was surprised. I told him, I thanked him in a kidding way. So you saved me a lot of money.
Almost 8 months later, Todd and Sarah's first child was born. They named him Track, after the sports season in which he was born. Over the next 19 years, four more children would come. Bristol, Willow, Piper, and Trigg. As a young mother in a small town, Sarah bonded with Kristen Cole and Judy Patrick. We caught up with them at the local gun club, where they shoot, socialize, and even once threw a baby shower for Sarah.
We used to get together, you know, in the summertime at the Lake Lucille Park, the three of us, and we would sit on the picnic table and eat our lunch and just talk about, you know, how we were doing. You know, gosh, if any of us needed help, what was going on in our lives. And
we were very aware of the need to balance our lives, because we all had busy careers. We all had futures that we knew were going to be bigger than what we were in at that moment.
Todd and Sarah raised their young children and pursued their interests. Todd worked as a commercial fisherman and an oilman and honed his skills as a champion snow machine racer. That's what they call snowmobiles up in Alaska. Sarah was too busy to continue at the TV station. She became active in the PTA and worked out at the local gym. There, she met Wasilla's mayor, John Stein.
Elections were coming up, so people are being scouted for possible candidacy in the city for the city council. And Sarah's name was suggested. Well, Sarah was invited to what I recall one meeting. Sarah came in and, of course, was very presentable, very energetic, very bright. And everybody said, yes, you know, this woman would be a great city council person.
With Stein's support and the kids in tow, Sarah Palin hit the Wasilla campaign trail.
She went door to door to every voter in the entire community. And sometimes she went door to door pulling a wagon with Track and Bristol, and Todd was at her side.
Personable, politically savvy, Sarah Palin used her skills, made a plan, and soon won herself a seat on city council. It was the first of many political surprises. When we come back, Sarah Palin plays hardball in Wasilla City Hall. Less than 5,000 people lived in Wasilla, Alaska, when Sarah Palin sat on the city council. It was 1996, and she was angry. Judy Patrick also served on the council.
She was very fiscally conservative and could see that the current administration wanted to build and had plans to build a new city hall, a new library, and I think a civic center of some sort.
Palin saw it as a wasteful use of tax dollars and decided to go after the mayor's job. Powerful Alaska state Republicans took note of this 32-year-old fresh face from Wasilla. Tom Kazaya reports for the Anchorage Daily News.
She was their up-and-coming star. They could see a future for her. And they were kind of greasing the skids.
John Stein was Wasilla's sitting mayor, Palin's opponent, and the target of a strong Republican campaign.
the issues that were brought in then were national issues, and that is abortion, gun rights, those kinds of things. And so when we said, well, you know, what's this got to do with roads, water, sewer, library, and the museum? And they said, all politics are local.
There was a kind of sub-race going on her behalf. And talk about her being a Christian mayor. It was time to have a Christian mayor.
Tom Keziah says that while various people were out promoting a Christian candidacy, it was a sort of whisper campaign that Sarah Palin never publicly supported. In the final tally, Sarah Palin received 616 votes. John Stein, 413, despite being a Christian and a Republican. In 4 years, Palin had shot through the ranks, from PTA mom to city councilwoman to mayor. One of Mayor Palin's first orders of business, clean house. She purged a number of department heads who wrote an editorial endorsing and supporting Mayor Stein.
And it was the bumpiest ride I've ever been on in my life.